but let me go briefly and give some additional inputs in a very short presentation, what sort of functions can offer to us. Everybody know this slide was prepared during the Internet Year of Soil in 2015. And I saw it also yesterday. God would kindly share this this slide. But I mean, it shows that soil offer a lot of things to us. And mostly, if you look for the perspective of a farmer or a forester, well, provision of food is the main important aspect for that. But we know that carbon sequestration can be also controlled by the soil, water purification. Carbon sequestration is strongly related with climate change. We discussed a lot about nutrients and nutrient cycling and all that thing happened within the soil. We said that the soil is very rich, is alive, and we know rather little about what is the microorganisms that are there. It can regulate floods. Actually, from those microorganisms, we also have some of the medicines that we use, and maybe we'll find more in the future. And let us don't forget also that soil protects our cultural heritage. If Pompeii was discovered because of the lava that came out of the Vesuvio eruption, so and then we built our homes in our in the soil. So it's an endless number of functions that they provide. Actually, they were also identified, some of them, during the EU thematic strategy back in 2006, which is already now being revised. So this is a summary of what these functions are. But the issue is now that whether we can maintain them on a long term. So that was mentioned, we heard a lot, is soil management. That is the topic in here. And if it is sustainable, it is because it has to produce to support also these services, like supporting, provisioning, regulating, and cultural services. And when they are maintained or enhanced without significantly impairing the soil functions, that those can enable also biodiversity. Well, FAO has also published the voluntary guidelines for sustainable soil management. Those reports are readily available. There are also publications also by colleagues of JRC, and we heard yesterday from Marvin Jones. So it's a lot of research ongoing. Now, if I go back to a slide that shows the soil threats, actually these soil threats in here were recognized in the EU thematic strategy, from erosion to soil method decline and contamination and so on. And those are strongly related with the soil function and soil processes. So it is an interlinkage between them, and they definitely will impact them, the ecosystem services. So if we erode, then we disturb the functions, and obviously we can also influence the biomass production or the biodiversity and many, and climate regulation as well. So it's an interconnection which goes on simultaneously throughout the time. Now, the soil properties, we heard a lot of, we still will hear about that, also physical, chemical, and biological ones, are interrelated and impact each other. We have identified here for the discussions these five soil functions: from productivity, soil biodiversity, carbon sequestration, nutrient cycling, and soil water storage and filtering. Actually, that's why we also clustered the focus groups based on these soil functions. And I take the liberty actually of using these pictures here, which were taken actually when we visited the farm of Mr. Coimbra. So this is the no-till and the cover crops that he is implementing in his own farm. So all those functions are interrelated and are enhanced by continuously supporting, let's say, each other. Yesterday was mentioned a question, what is soil health? And I thought it was actually good to kind of give a kind of definition. It says that it's defined as the capacity of the soil to function as a vital living ecosystem to sustain plants, animals, and humans. And there are several criteria that we can consider in terms of estimating the soil health, from organic matter dynamics and carbon sequestration, soil structure stability, general microbial activity, carbon food source, bioavailable nitrogen, and microbial community and diversity. Now, in the US, they also even have a Soil Health Institute, and I took the liberty to use one of the slides that they have produced, the four soil health principles. So minimum disturbance, maximize soil cover, maximize biodiversity, and maximize continuous living roots. And we had also some discussion yesterday, one of the breakout sessions. So this is very briefly how we can relate the soil properties with the soil functions and the soil health.